Hello students, grade 3 children. Today we will discuss your third chapter, subtraction. Okay, so subtraction, as you know already in your class 2, you did, if we subtract same number, the answer will be 0. 100 minus 100 will be 0. So this way you can start your chapter by the introduction of the chapter, and these things you have, this phase you have to write in the notebook. Okay, I have written here notebook also. 148 minus 8, you know 8 minus 8 is 0, and 14 will be as it, 140. And if you want to subtract 555 minus 515, directly you can subtract like this. 5 minus 5 is 0, write in the last, and 5 minus 1 is 4, you can write here, and 5 minus 5 is 0, no need to write 0, no number will start with 0. Same way you can try for these two parts. If there is 600 minus 400, two zeros as it, you have to write in the last, and 6 minus 4 is 2, so answer is 200. And if 920 minus 20 is there, 20 you can subtract, and it will be 900. 20 minus 20 is 0. So this you have to write in the notebook. Now subtract on number line. You all know number line, how to subtract on number line. If it is 14 minus 9, this is like activity you can do in the notebook. You directly go from draw a number line by using your skill. Directly go to 14, 0 to 14, and come 5 step back. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. You will reach at 9. So answer is 9. Now this is for you. You can do yourself. 9 minus 3, 0 to 9 you have to go directly, then 3 step back. Then find the answer. Then we did in class 2 subtraction without regrouping. You did for 2 digit number in class 2. Now we will start for 3 digit number. You see here, without regrouping means if downside numbers are less than upside numbers. So 8 minus 5 is 3. 3 minus 2, you know, 3 fingers up, 2 down, then it is 1. And 4 minus 1, 4 finger up and 1 down, 3. So this way you can do the subtraction. Same way, 3 minus 0, any number minus 0 is the same number, and 1 minus 1 means same number. If you are subtracting, answer is 0. 6 minus 5 is 1. Other parts for you, you can do all these 3 parts yourself. Now let's go. I will tell you again about subtraction with regrouping, means with borrow. You did for 2 digit number, now let's start for 3 digit number. 4 is greater than 3, so you can't subtract 4 from 3, 3 is small, so take a borrow from 2. When you take a borrow from 2, 2 becomes 1, and this 3 becomes 13, so 13 minus 4 becomes 9 here, and 1 you can take for this, because 9 you can't subtract from 1, so 1 becomes 0, and here it is 11, 11 minus 9 is 2, 29. And here you can see 9 is again more than 8. So take a borrow from 7. 7 becomes 6, one number back. And 8 becomes 18. And you know 18 minus 9 is 9. And 6 is there. 6 minus 4 is 2. And here 6 minus 4, 2 is 4. Here only one time you took borrow. But here we have to take 2 times, because 1 was left and that is less than 9. So like this you can do subtraction using borrow. Now if you want to see this one, 725 minus 626, so here also 2 times you have to take borrow. You take 1 time, it becomes 15, and this becomes 1. 1 left here, 15 minus 6 is 9, but 1 is there. 1 minus 2 you can't do, 2 is more than 1. Again you have to take borrow. So second borrow you take from 7, 7 becomes 6. And here it becomes 11, 11 minus 2 is 9, 6 minus 6 is 0, no need to write. So these two parts you can do yourself. Now we will come to the, now you can do rest of the parts yourself in the notebook. Now we will, I will discuss you this exercise 3A. Before that, you can see there are some questions in page number 49. Question number 1 is there, subtract regrouping, regroup if necessary. So you can regroup 13 here, 0 here, 30 minus 7 is 6. You can do all these parts. And these parts you can do in your notebook. 48 minus 10 like this, 48 minus 10, you know. 8 minus 0 is 8, 4 minus 1 is 3. So this question you have to do in notebook and this in the book. Now we will go for the exercise 3A, page number. This is page number 51, exercise 3A. So you can see, first question, it says 35 minus some number is equal to 15. This first and second, this is fill in the blanks type, but you have to do in notebook. Full exercise in notebook. NB, I'm writing here. So I will tell you how you can do. If any number you have to subtract, some number you have to subtract from 35 to get 15, then also you have to do subtraction. 35 minus 15 is 10. 5 minus 5, 0, and here it is 20. So what will come here? 20. Same way here, at 139 minus 37 you can do. So this, but if there is addition, then also you have to do subtraction. 83 is there. 35 plus some number is equal to 83. What is that number? That also you have to find by subtraction. Okay, so here also you have to use subtraction. Here also, if addition is there to one side, one is blank. I'm giving you simple example. If I say what number should be added to 8, simple example, I'm telling you 8 plus what number is equal to 10. After 8, you have to see up to 10, 9, 10, or you can do 10 minus 8, 2. Okay, and if subtraction is there, 10 minus which number is equal to 8. So from 8 8 to 10 you have to count 9, 10. So 10, or you can do like this, 10 minus 8 is 2. So 2. So this is the example to understand. So you have to write like this in the notebook. 35 minus 10, we did already, that is 20. You have to write here 20. So here 81 minus something is 81 minus 43 you can do. So you can subtract yourself and do it like this. And here also I have given you second type, question number 2. 83 minus this one 13, here it is 7, here it is 13 minus 5 is 8 and 4. So what you will write here? 48. Same way, 21 plus a number is 75, means 75 minus 21, that number is 75 minus 21. Here also subtraction, 4, 5, 54. So this way you can do the full these parts, question number 1 and 2. Now question number 3 we will do. Third is the applications in the real life. The question is, the teacher had 37 notebooks to correct. She corrected some of the notebooks. Okay, there are still 12 notebooks left to be corrected. So how many notebooks has he corrected so far? So how to make the statement? Total notebooks to correct is equal to 37 notebooks left to correct, 12 notebooks corrected so far. You can subtract, it is 5 to 25. Now for second question, Chetan is reading a book of 75 pages. Okay, Chetan is reading a book of 75 pages. He has read 39 pages so far. How many more pages does he need to read to finish the book? That this is also subtraction. So total pages to read 75, pages read so far 39. Then more pages to read, you can subtract. It is 15 here and here it is 6. 15 minus 9 is 6. 6 minus 3 is 3. So 36 is the answer. Next is, a new pair of the shoes cost 250. Cost of the new pair of the shoes is 250. And then you can, Amit has 195 with him. 195 rupees he has. So he need more money because 195 is not good enough. 250 he needs. So you have to subtract and find his more money needed. So that you can do by subtraction. And I'm giving you this. You can do like this. 10. Here it is 4. And here it is, then 4 become 14, because 9 is there, this becomes 1. 10 minus 5 is 5, 14 minus 9 is again 5, 1 minus 1 is 0. So it is rupees 55. So last is, Anushree was making flags for the Red Cross Day. She had to make 58 flags in all, 58 flags she has to make. 11 flag, by evening she had made 14 flags more. How many flags had she made during the day? Evening time she has made 14 flags made. Anushree was making flags for Red Cross Day. She had to make 58 flags in all. 58 flags she has to make. By evening she had made 14 flags more. How many flags had she made during the day? Evening she made only 14, but she has to make 58 in the full day, so you subtract it. 4, and here also 4. 44 flags during the day and 14 during the evening, so total flag will be 58. So this way you can do this exercise. Now we'll go further. You can pause and write it in the notebook, this page. Now we'll go to the next page. 52, that is fill in the blanks type 52, you can do yourself. Now we will go directly to exercise 3B, subtraction, regroup the tens, regroup the 100, regroup both tens and 100. So here actually in this exercise I will give you two parts for all the questions and two you. These type of parts you have to do in the notebook, these all. And the left parts like EFGH of all this in the notebook, because there is no space to subtract, you can do in the notebook. ABCD for all the question you can do in the book like this. Let's see, regrouping. 8 is more than 6, you can take a borrow from 6, from 9, it becomes 8 and 6 becomes 16. 16 minus 8 is 8 and 8 minus 3 is 5 and 7 will be here. So here you can take borrow 13 and here it is 6, 13 minus 7 is 6 and here it is 4 and 5. So this way you can do. Now next is regroup the 100, ones, tens, 100. So here 2 minus 1 is 1, regrouping is here, okay, from 100 is it. So 7 becomes 6 and this 3 becomes 13, so 13 minus 4 is 9 and 6 minus 5 is 1. So we will go for the second part. 6 minus 4 is 2 and here you need the regrouping, borrow, take 11 and here it becomes 8, 11 minus 9, 5 is 6, 8 minus 3 is 5. This way you can do other parts and these parts in the notebook. Now regrouping both tens and 2 times you have to take regrouping, because 9 is more than 6, 8 is more than 2. So here also regrouping, here also. So first you take here, it becomes 16 and this 2 becomes 1 actually. Now first you subtract this. 16 minus 9 is 7. Now you can't subtract 8 from 1. Take a borrow from here, it becomes 8 and this is 11. 11 minus 8 is your 3 and 8 minus 3 is 5. Same way here, one more part I will do. Here this becomes 11. 11 minus 8 is 3 and this is 3 left here, but 8 can't be subtracted from 3. You take the borrow from 8, 8 becomes 7, 4 becomes 3 becomes 13, 13 minus 8 is 5, 7 minus 5 is 2. So this way you can do all the parts. Same way question number 4, I will do two parts. Here it is 13, 13 minus 6 is 7, here 1 left, 1 minus 5 you can't do, take a borrow from here, 11 minus 5 is 6 and 6 minus 4 is 2. Now you see here 2 minus 1 is 1 and here second part I am doing 16. 16 minus 9 is 7. Take borrow wherever it is needed. It is not needed here, don't take. Now here it is 7. 7 minus 3 is 4. So this way you can do all the parts of the left parts of the exercise 3B. Now we'll go further for the next exercise 3C. 3C is quite easy. Now it is again by regrouping, or somewhere you have to regroup. So this question number 1 you have to do in the book only. Space is already given there. So you can take this borrow. Here it becomes 10. 10 minus 8 is 2. Here it is 8. 8 minus 4 is 4. And 6 minus 2 is 4. Same way if there are 100. Now you see this part is important. When 0 zeros are there, you 4 you can't subtract from 0, 1 you can't subtract from 0, so borrow you have to take from here. This is 3, 3 becomes 2 and when you take borrow it becomes 10 here, but you have to take borrow further, so 10 become here 9 and in the last it becomes 10. Now circle digit you have to, numbers you have to use. 10 minus 4 is 6, 9 minus 1 is 8, 2 minus 1 is 1. Again I am telling you for zeros, this from here you have to take borrow, because you can't take from here. It becomes 5, this becomes 10 and this become 10. Now cut 10. Actually 9 it becomes here. You have to use 9. 10 minus 3, 7 is 3. 9 minus 5 is 4. 5 minus 2 is 5 minus 2 is 3. Now if it is 801 minus this one, so you take a borrow from here. It becomes 7. This becomes 10 first. Then it becomes 9. And here it is 11. 11 minus 8 is 3, 9 minus 6 is 3, 7 minus 5 is 2. So this way you can do question number 1 in the book and question number 2 in the notebook. In the notebook you have to write like this, 360 minus 142 in the column, vertically columns, and then you can subtract by taking borrow. And question number 3, using the pattern that is done already there, you can do, it's easy. So this question in notebook, it is written also, 1 and 3 in the book.